Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise Jesus.
Hallelujah.
You know, when Pastor was saying that, he said, if my neighbor will not go, I will go. And then he said, perhaps, after I have helped myself, I could go back. The Spirit of the Lord just dropped in my heart the parable of the virgin with the lamb and the oil. You know, he said perhaps, but the Spirit of God is saying perhaps you can't. Because we know the story of the virgin with the lamb and the oil. The ones that had the oil could not help those that didn't have the oil. Perhaps. I want you to write that down, because that is very deep. And that message is for somebody here. You are waiting. You say, let me really see what's going to happen before I decide or make up my mind. Perhaps. Perhaps. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I am so excited today. And maybe, you know, when I came here and the worship started, I'm sure people that are around here, because we were few when we started, they'll be looking at me like, what's wrong with her? She should be looking around to see people coming. It's not about that. In fact, we really did not advertise this program. I was restricted. I told a few people, my close friends, but a lot of people don't know about this program because it's not about the crowd. When Gideon was called, he thought it was about the crowd. You know, he blew that trumpet and everybody came running. God said, no, I don't need a crowd. And then he said, okay, God, you don't need a crowd. Let me do some attrition. He did the best he could. God said, it's not good enough. Still too many people. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Congratulate yourself that you are here. Say, I congratulate myself
that
I'm here today. Now, congratulate your neighbor. Say, congratulations that you are here today. Praise the Lord. I just want to believe that all of us that is seated here today will be likened as the virgin that have some extra oil. Please, don't be part of those that don't have the oil. For perhaps. Praise the Lord. I'm going to go straight to the message. I'm just going to follow the Holy Spirit and let him say what he wants to say. And we go as far as we can today, and we continue tomorrow. Praise the Lord. And I want to let you know that whatever I'm teaching this evening is fresh from God, is rhema. Because up to today, I didn't know what I was going to. God gave me the topic, you know what I'm saying? And then my heart was just full of a lot of things. A lot of them, like, God, we will need months to do this kind of teaching. It's just two-day program. Then I've learned, you know, I said, okay, God, I know you come through, you know. So, and we've been so busy, extremely busy, you don't understand. So I was telling Pastor when we came for the early morning prayer today, I said, I haven't prepared, you know. He said, well, okay. So we finished the prayer and then I stayed behind to put a few things here and there. And then we happened to have some guests in our house also. And I thought, okay, I will just go back home and go and sit down. That's what I call it. So I will sit down and hear. And I thank God. As soon as I got in and I sat down, God gave me once God gave me the major chapter and verse, it becomes really easy for other things to come. So that came to me and I was excited and I was still sitting there. And then I was so distracted because I guess needed this one and that one, and I was just doing, you know, up and down. And he came in, he stayed in church and came in and saw me. I said, do you believe I haven't done anything? I said, go and pray. He laughed. So I sat down, but God spoke. And I'm so happy because it doesn't matter how much I have. If God has not spoken, it's not rhema. But if God speaks, it's the rhema word. Because the Bible says, the word that I speak to you, they are spirit and they are life. You see, it's not the logos that matter. Let me tell you, some people can stand up here and quote a whole chapter, and yet they don't have any revelation about that word. And have revelation of the word of God, it cannot profit you. What's the point of having a gun when it's not loaded? Somebody tell me. You have a gun. You want to go and fight. And your gun is not loaded. In fact, somebody that doesn't have a gun is better than you. Do you know why? Because the person that doesn't have a gun will be smart enough to know not to expose themselves. But when you have a gun and it's not loaded and you are proud and you go thinking that you are ready, it will not be a portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So let me tell you something. We need the revelation of the word. And like I always say, revelation cannot come from your mind. It cannot come from you being smart. It cannot come from you cramming the word. It comes from the Holy Spirit. And you can only hear him when you do what? How do you listen? Hallelujah. Pastor God is. Because I've said it over and over again. I said the first thing you need to do, sit down. Tell your neighbor, sit down. If you don't sit down, you cannot listen. Just sit down first and don't be anxious to get up. Just sit there. Wait for him to come. He will come. Praise the Lord. So today, the title of our message today is How to Live in the Glory of God. Applying God's word to life's experiences. Oh my God. Wouldn't it be great if you have answer to all the challenges of life? Do you understand what I'm saying? You just have answer to every challenge that comes along your way. Is that not what we want? And let me tell you something. You don't get it from being smart. You don't get it from going to college. In fact, you don't get it from going to Bible school. Praise the Lord. We will learn how we're going to get it today. Praise the Lord!
Hallelujah.
How many here wants to see the glory of God? You really, 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 really want to see the glory of God. Hallelujah. I want to. You know, I've been praying for years and years and years. Oh God, show me your glory. Show me your glory. You know what I'm saying? I pray it all the time. And I intensify the prayer. Few months ago, particularly after God gave me this like glory, glory just kept coming to my spirit. I said, what about this glory? Okay, maybe it's time. Okay, God, let me pray the more. Show me your glory. And I prayed. One night, I slept and I had a revelation. And up till now, I still, you know when you have some revelation, and you know what happened in that revelation, but by the time you wake up, you can't put it together. I don't know. I mean, that was the problem that John had in Revelation. You know, when he just started to see some strange things and then he had to put it in human world. I don't know how he did it, but he tried. And you see, one thing that amazed me in Revelation, when he went into the throne room of God and then he said he saw four beasts in the presence of God. You know, after I gave my life to Christ, and I started reading the Bible, you know, and I go to Revelation. And I said, four beasts. I don't want to go to where beasts are. Do you understand what I'm saying? In our own human mind, when they say a beast is coming, what do? You run. So I now read the book of Revelation. And John said, in the presence of God, there were four beasts. I'm like, I don't want to read Revelation. Let me read. But then, with time, I started to understand that to John, that was the best way he could describe those creatures. Do you understand what I'm saying? Because on the earth, we have formed a way of thinking based on what is familiar to us. When I see a man, I know this is a man, right? And I know the feature the man is supposed to have. If that man have a different feature, he's a beast. To me. Do you understand? So when John got there and then he saw, there's one. The head is like that of a man. The body is like a horse. I'm like, okay. Another one with the head of a lion. So he said, okay, how can I describe these four creatures? They are beasts. Praise the Lord. But you know, I have a good news for somebody. They are not beasts. So I'm not afraid anymore to go into the throne room. I'm not afraid to go in the presence of God. They are creatures that God created for himself, filled with his glory. My perception is different, but God does not see them like that. Because God is holy, he won't want no beasts around him. You understand what I'm saying? But when we look at that, our own perception is different. So from this little story that I told you, because most of the time when, in fact, all the time, when the Spirit of God brings a story to my spirit like that, it's for a purpose. I'm just not telling you a story. God is telling you that your perception all the time is different from his perception. We see those creatures as beasts. To him, they are beautiful. In the presence of the Almighty God, radiating his glory. Because the Bible says they cry day and night, holy, 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 Lord God Almighty. Heaven and earth are filled with your glory. Before beasts. But to John, they were beasts. So please, the places where God is taking us, he's going to start to show you some things that when you try to reason it with your mind, you perceive it differently. And when you perceive it differently, it becomes impossible for you to partake of what God is trying to give you. Praise the Lord. But that's why we have the Holy Spirit. And that's why I was telling you that studying the word does not cut it. It comes by revelation. Because the Holy Spirit is going to come and sit with you and will tell you what God means when he starts to show you strange things. Praise the Lord. Praise Jesus. Our text today is just one verse, which we're going to expand on. And it's a very common verse. John chapter 11 verse 40. John chapter 11 verse 40. Jesus said unto her, said I not unto thee that if thou wouldest believe, thou shouldest see the glory of God? I want you to read that verse to yourself and personalize it. Personalize it. Jesus said unto me, Buki, if thou wouldest believe, thou shouldest see the glory of God. Hallelujah. We all want to see the glory of God. Here comes the answer. If thou shouldest believe. That takes me back to my, I didn't finish my revelation. Praise the Lord. So in that revelation, God was telling me, he said, you've been praying for my glory. He said, you've been praying for my glory. I said, yes. He said, you have it. I'm like, eh? I do? You know? He said, you just need to do something. And in that revelation, that thing that I needed to do was so little. I'm like, okay, so why am I not doing it? I want it so bad. And it all depends on me. I'm crying to God, thinking that everything depends on him. But he said, you have it. Just do that little thing. And in that dream, I told God, I said, yes, I will do it. Then I woke up. I'm like, what did I say I would do? Oh my God, what did I say I would do? And it did not come to me until today when I started preparing for this message. I said, God, thank you. Because if I was not obedient, first, to hold this program, two, to go by the title that the Lord gave to me, I wouldn't have found what I missed in the dream. Obedience is so paramount. We can do without it. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Anyway, the Lord spoke to me. Hallelujah. And I'm so excited. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So, John chapter 11 verse 40 says, if you will believe, you, not somebody else, not the bishop, not the pastor, not the Pope, not the prophetess, you, an ordinary person. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. We're still going to expand on that. We will expand on that. I want you to keep that somewhere at the corner. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now, let's try to define the glory of God. Let's try. Or let us allow the Holy Spirit. Because whatever I'm going to tell you today did not come to me from trying. Because I was trying. I said, God, it's too many things. How can I? What is it? Which one? And by the time the Holy Spirit expanded it to me, I started to jump up. I said, oh my God, that's why in the dream God said it's not as difficult as I thought. Praise the Lord. And God is going to reveal it to everyone that is here today. And my prayer is that the eye of your understanding would be enlightened to understand. Because if you do not understand, you cannot receive. Those are the words that Satan steals. The word that you understand and you have a revelation of, he can't steal it. It's impossible. But when you don't understand it, when you don't perceive it, when you don't have a revelation, you can't keep it. But today, God will grant everyone that is seated to hear the sound of my voice today to have revelation in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Because that is the reason why we're here. He will do what he said he will do. Praise the Lord. So, let's start from what the glory of God is not. That's the way we're going to go. What is the glory? Glory of God is not one. Is not worldly form. Worldly. I'm talking about the world. Worldly form. Like things that we see in this world. Now, it might appear or manifest like that. It's two different things. Manifestation is different from the real thing. And I will give you the example of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is not a dove. Right? But he can manifest as a dove. We all know that when he came on Jesus Christ, he manifested as a dove. The Holy Spirit is not fire, but he manifests as fire. Holy Spirit is not wind. He manifests as wind. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
But yet, sometimes, in fact, most of the time, he's present and he chooses not to manifest himself. So, also, the Holy Spirit is nothing. I'm talking about physical now. Physically, we sit here. He's here. How can you tell? By faith. But he's there. And then sometimes he decides to manifest himself by the things that we can see. That is the same thing as the glory of God. Praise the Lord. So the glory of God is not things, but he can manifest as things. And from the word of God, I will tell you the things that, the way that the whole, the glory of the Lord has manifested, recorded in the word, thunder. You know the glory of God is not thunder. But it manifests as thunder sometimes. Lightning, bright light, cloud, fire, noise, different noises, sometimes like a trumpet, sometimes a earthquake. As the dew, as the rain, as signs and in fact, any way God chooses, he can manifest. Let me put it that way. Because there's some things that are recorded, and there's some things that happen in our time that were never recorded. There were some things that happened in the great move of God that happened before our time that was not recorded in the Bible. The glory of God. Maria Wadwood Ether, you know, great signs and wonder, woman of God. He might be preaching like I'm preaching now. And he will do like, she will do like this. And she will freeze. For hours. Some people will freeze like that for days. In her time, it became so, you know, the police. They were after them because they would go to their gathering, you know, wanting to see. And they told a story of a lady that froze like that. And every hefty man around came to move her. They couldn't. And she was like that for 3 days. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Anyway, that's a sign and wonder. So God will manifest in any way he wants to. Some people, they have oil coming out of their hand. Oil will just be coming. Real oil. Because they will put their hand near a cup and the cup can get filled up. That's the glory of God. If God chooses to manifest like that. Different ways. Different ways. I just recently read about a man that he will be covered with dust made of gold. Just, he'll be preaching and you just start seeing the speckles, and before you know it, your face is covered. So God will manifest the way he chooses to manifest, but that those manifestations are not the glory of God. They are the manifestation of the glory of God. Praise the Lord. So we see that the glory of God is not worldly form, but he can manifest like that. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Now, the glory of God is not a force and energy that floats around, you know. You know, spooky and like that. He can manifest like that, but that's not the glory of God. Because people, and the reason why God is teaching us all this is that we seek after things. You know what I'm saying? You seek after things. If somebody comes to tell you now that, there's somebody, oil is coming up, you will run there. Or there's somebody, fire, you run there. We don't need to run helter-skelter. God will tell us what his glory is today. And it's available to all of us. Say, I will see the glory of God in the name of Jesus. The glory of God is not magic. Abracadabra, you know. The more you look, the less you see. That is not the glory of God. Unfortunately, a lot of people are doing that in the church today because people are seeking after things. You know, before you see it, you know, they change. That is not the glory of God. Praise the Lord. Now, let's see what the glory of God is. What is the glory of God? Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I sat down there, and the Lord told me that the glory of God is the essence of God. The essence of God. And I'm going to break that down. After God told me that the essence, what is essence? I had to go and study that. Because remember, the Holy Spirit comes together with us to help us. We are not passive. And then he's telling us that whatever you can do on your own part, you do it. He gives you the help. I said, okay, what is the essence? What is essence? And then I realized that the essence of a thing is the thing that makes up that matter. Do you understand? The essence of a thing is the reality of that thing, the invariability nature of that thing, the significant individuality of that thing, the specific thing of that thing. And I will give you an example. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The essence of a plant is what you get from that plant. That the essence of a plant makes up the plant. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So when you extract a concentrate from a plant, that is the essence of that plant. That's where pharmacology comes from. You know, they get all these plants and they get what is in them. Because that thing that is in them is useful for something. And then they extract those concentrates and then they form them into tablets. And then when you take the tablets, it solves your problem. Hallelujah. We have some essence, some concentrates in God that is made available to solve the issues of life. And the good thing about the essence of God is not specific for anything. Hallelujah!
Amen.
I am that I am. Does anybody know the meaning of I am that I am? Do you know? Because one day I told God, I said, I am that I am. Okay, what is I am that I am? Because Moses said, okay, God, you sent me to these people. Who are you? God said, I am that I am. God told me, I am that I am. I will be anything that you want me to be for you. Praise the Lord. That is the meaning of I am that I am. If you need a healer, he's your healer. If you need money, he's your provider. If you need peace, he gives you peace. Whatever you need, he becomes that thing to you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The glory of God. You know, the Hebrew word for glory is kabod. Kabod. What is kabod? Kabod means the weight. The weightiness of something. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You know, when I stand on a scale, let's say I strip myself naked and I stand on a scale, that scale tells me all that is in me. Do you understand what I'm saying? That is all of me. Nothing taken away and nothing added to it. The glory of God is the weight of the Almighty God. The weight of the Almighty God. The root word of glory is weight. Kabod. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So the glory of God is the substance of God. What makes him God? So if you come to God asking for his glory, you are not asking for something light. I mean, if somebody comes to me now and say, I want all of you. Do you understand what I'm saying? We understand what it means for somebody to have all of you. In fact, that thing is so, the price on it is so high that God has designed it that is only one person that can have all of somebody. Do you understand what I'm saying? We human beings, the only person that can have all of you is your spouse. The weight of God, the weight, the totality, the essence, the consistency of God in himself. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So how many still wants to see his glory? Hallelujah. I want to. Praise the Lord. Now, let me make you happy. Because when I went through all this definition, I'm sure somebody is thinking, this glory thing, I don't know if I will qualify. You know what I'm saying? The whole of God, will I qualify? You know, you're already thinking in your mind, what do I need to do? Because, you know, when I used to pray for the glory of God, I would say, okay, God, just tell me what I need to do to get it. Just tell me. Whatever, I will do it. And I'm sure God will be looking at me. And look at this girl. It's not like that. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Tell your neighbor, it's easier than you think.
It's
easier than you think. Say it
again. It's easier than you think.
Now say it to yourself. It's easier than I think. Aren't you happy?
Yeah.
Let me see that you're happy. Show it to me.
Yeah.
Woo! Hallelujah. Glory! Hallelujah! Because when God showed it to me, I jumped up from where I was sitting and I was jumping up and down. Because I said, oh my God, so this is it. Hallelujah. Ah, let's go to John chapter 1, verse 1. John chapter 1 verse 1, the gospel of John, it says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Now, I'm going to read that to you from the expanded version, and I want you to listen very carefully. In the beginning there was the Word. The Word already existed. The Word refers to Christ, God's revelation of Himself. The Word was with, in the presence of, in intimate relationship with God. Now look at this last one. Look at it. This is it. And the Word was fully God. Ha! Oh, glory, hallelujah. This is it. This is it. We want the glory. The glory is the Word. The Word of God. That is what makes God God. You want to know the weight of God and the fullness of God is the Word of God. No wonder. No wonder. I began to think. I said, no wonder all the great men of God that have demonstrated the glory of God are men of the Word. The fullness of God, the totality of God, the weight of God, the essence of God is in the Word. If it's not in the Word, it is not God. So do we still think it's easy? It is very easy. But are we ready? Because this Word that I'm talking about is not from you putting the Bible on your head. It's not from you putting it under your pillow when you sleep. It, in fact, it is not from you reading it from Genesis to Revelation. It's more than that. Is from you meditating on it and having revelation. The more the revelation of the Word that you have, the more God you have. Don't be running up and down anymore looking for the glory of God. You have it in your pocket. In fact, most of us carried it when we were coming here. Just do something about it. Do something about it. Tell your neighbor, I'm able. Why is it that we can do everything but meditate on the Word? Why is it so difficult? We do anything. But when it comes to the time to meditate on the Word, we can't do it. That will stop in the name of Jesus. Amen. Because that is the strategy coming from the pit of hell. When you meditate on the Word of God, there and no wonder God told Joshua. Do you understand? Why did you think God said nobody will be able to stand before you all your life? Amen. Amen. You know, we all quote the scripture. You say, according to what God said to Joshua, just as Joshua, nobody will be able to stand. And yet, everybody is standing before you and slapping your face. And then you will say, okay, maybe the Word is just saying it. It's not real. You understand? We have learned to accommodate things. We say, okay, you know, I do my best. You know, it's because we don't have the revelation of the Word. Why is it? Because Joshua listened to the instruction that God gave him. God said, the book of the law shall not depart out of your mouth. You will meditate on it day and night. And from that you will make your way prosperous. Is that somebody that wants to be prosperous here? Let me tell you something. The answer to the issue of life is in the glory of God, in the Word of God. We think that the spiritual is different from the physical, you know? It's time to go to church. You carry the spiritual aspect of you. Church time. Hallelujah, you know? You come to church. And then when Monday comes, flesh time. My mind and my soul. Let's go and try. And make the best of today. Let me do it the way Jones and Johnsons are doing it. I work harder. I do this other, I do that one. Then you go to your friend again. What's the new thing that people are doing now? They tell you, you quickly go and do it before a lot of people know about it. It's not like that. It's in the word. It's in the word. That's why God told Joshua, you will meditate on this thing day and night. Your way will be prosperous. And you will do what? Have good success. Not ordinary success. Who is seated here that wants success? I want success. But let me tell you something. It's not from working hard. Ask your neighbor. They will tell you. Except somebody that wants to lie. Who is it in this room that is not working hard? Tell me. Tell me. It is in the word of God. The glory of God. And God has proven it in people's life. Over and over and over and over again. And let me tell you something. I'm not supporting people that preach about money and money and money all the time. I'm not. But let me tell you something. Those prosperity preachers, they know the word. Do you understand what I'm saying? People talk about Creflo Dollar. I used to fight with my husband. The Bible says don't judge anything except when the time comes. But one thing I can testify about Creflo Dollar, he knows the word of God. Please, don't be talking about the man. He is loaded. He is not an empty gun. He is loaded with the word of God. He is loaded with revelation. The word will make you prosper. Amen. Now, when the money comes, what you do after that is between you and your God. But what I'm saying is that you cannot have revelation like that of the word and you will not prosper. It's not possible. And it's not dependent on what you are doing. It's not. We all know that concerning Jacob. We know that about Abraham. We know that about Isaac. It's about the word. And then Joshua. How can a man, ordinary man, nobody was able to stand before him? And then we think that, oh, God just elevated him. And then you go to God in prayer. Elevate me. Elevate. You know what I'm saying? You pray for elevation. 50 years, you are still praying for elevation. Let's tell your neighbor, change your strategy.
Change your strategy.
I'm not saying don't pray. In fact, prayer is so important. But when you pray like that without the word, it can't happen. It cannot. Because the glory of the Lord is in the word of God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The Bible says Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Hebrews 13:8. The word is the same. The word is God. The word is Jesus. The word is the weightiness of God. Is the kabod of God. Is the essence of God. When you squeeze God, the word comes out. When you turn God upside down, word spill out. When you sit him right up, the word will come. That's why he's always speaking. He's a speaking spirit. And that's the way he creates us. He made us speaking spirit. That is why there is no word that is effective in your life if you have not put it in your mouth. Tell your neighbor, put the word in your mouth.
Put the word in your mouth.
They don't teach us that, but you are being taught today. The word that you have not put in your mouth cannot profit you and have not profited you yet. And that's why the Bible says, this book of the law shall not depart out of your mouth. When I first gave my life to Christ, I thought it was a mistake. When I read this, I said, shall not depart out. I said, this Bible, you know, those people that are translating it, they put mouth. But really, I said, how is it possible that the word of God will not depart from your mouth? The Bible meant it. Give it a try. I'm telling you, just make up your mind that the word of God will not depart out of your mouth. You will start to see strange things. And when they start to happen to you, you will look around you. Say, is there somebody, is it me or is somebody else doing it? Yes, somebody else is doing it. It's the word. The weightiness of God. The glory of God. The essence of God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. So, ladies and gentlemen, what am I saying today? The solution to the issues of life is the word of God. And I don't care what it is. Because some people will say, you are getting too spiritual now. You are getting, and what about this? And what about that? Let me tell you something. It is everything. Everything. And I have learned in my own life that God cares. Somebody will say, God does not care whether you eat rice and beans or you eat a bag. God cares. Do you understand what I'm saying? That's why the Bible says, in all your way, acknowledge him.